get back! I'm warning you!
Someone's in trouble. Are you all right?
Hi.
What do they want with you?
Yuki, and you lot too. I don't know. We were returning from the Enclave when they came at us.
It seems they won't go quietly.
And neither will we.
It is nothing.
Thank you.
That seems to be the last of them. You have nothing to fear, child. You are safe now.
Thank you, sir.
You saved us again. Thank you. If you're ever passing by our village, look us up. You'll always be welcome.
Thank goodness we arrived when we did.
Indeed. But what could have prompted the Red Codin to stray so far from the Ruby Sea?
I presume these are the sellswords hired by Yotsu. If so, the answer is simple. Desperation. Bereft of Imperial employment, they seek other means to line their coin purses. Another sad legacy of the Empire's mismanagement.
The Empire to which you have sworn allegiance.
Must you always be so pointed? If we are to bring about lasting change, we must look beyond narrow allegiances. You have every right to doubt me, but in time, I hope you will come to see that we share a common goal. You and yours have fought fiercely to change the Empire from without, but if we are to end the cycle of conflict, the Empire must change from within. Am I wrong? Never? I wonder, would you have said the same of Ishgard? Believe what you will, but I assure you, the Empire can change.
I had her brought here in secret while the three of you kept our guest company. The world has not been kind to you, it is true. But that does not excuse your sins. You should be at the bottom of the river. Yet here you are, the living, breathing proof of my failure. A failure for which I would now make amends.
What did I do? I don't remember. Was it really so terrible? Tell me, please! What did I do?
You speak of sins, my lord. But at whose feet do those sins lie? With the soldiers who committed the crimes, or those who commanded them to do so? With both, I would say. For all have a conscience, and all must choose. But with no memory of who she is or what she has done, what sin remains to be cleansed?
You ask that I show mercy?
I ask why the heavens saw fit to deny me my rest. Why Yotsuyu was spared not only death, but the bitter memories of her life.
You truly think it the will of the Kami? If so, her life is not mine to take. It is yours to safeguard. Come the hour of the exchange. If her memories have not returned, she may remain here in Doma to live out her days as Tsuyu. But if they do, the Guardians shall have their viceroy. Though the people will protest, they will come to accept my decision when they have been reunited with their loved ones.
Thank you, my lord.
Now then. I believe we have kept our guests waiting long enough. Did Gorsetsu not seem strange to you? His sympathy for Yotsuyu apart, I mean. I know his powers of endurance only too well, but after all he has suffered, even he should not be on his feet. He puts on a brave face for our sakes, but it would not surprise me if he lacked the strength to raise his blade. Though I suppose if he and Yotsuyu are to enjoy a life of peace and quiet, he will have little use for it. It falls to us to shape that future, one in which he need never again set foot on the battlefield. My apologies. Our deliberations took longer than expected.
Think nothing of it. The time afforded me the opportunity to go on a rather rousing excursion through Yansha. You have reached a decision, then?
We are willing to cooperate with you in combating the Icon threat, and also in the exchange of prisoners. Assuming you accept our conditions, of course. As you know, your sister is in our care. Due to certain complications, however, we are hesitant to release her into your custody.
Complications?
She was inside Doma Castle when it collapsed. Though she survived, she remembers nothing of her past life, not even her name. To clarify, she is in our care not as a prisoner, but as a vulnerable citizen of Doma.
Are you saying you refuse to release her?
Not at all. If her memory returns before the appointed hour.
And if not, what exactly? You will accommodate her here in Doma?
Well, I sincerely doubt she will be of any great strategic value to the Empire. She spends her days daydreaming of Dango.
Dango? How dreadful. Very well. In light of our recent misstep in Sakazuki, it seems only fair that I show you the same understanding you have shown us. Though I do have one small request. Regardless of Yotsuyu's value to the Empire, she is yet my sister. Before I leave, might you permit me to speak with her in private?
Of course. Perhaps you could even bring her a plate of dango. She would be most pleased. Yugiri will see you to her chambers.
Thank you.
I wish you a safe journey.
This has been a most enjoyable visit. I look forward to our next meeting. Maxima, would you take the others and see that all is ready for our departure? I simply cannot leave without first giving thanks to the Warrior of Light for accompanying me through Yansha. Mark me, savior of the savages. There will be a reckoning.
Traitor!
Ignorant savages! Killing us will avail you naught. For every Imperial you cut down, 1,000 more will come. Abandon this foolish endeavor and surrender. You may yet serve our righteous cause.
How dare you speak of righteousness? You, who forsook kith and kin to serve conquerors! Be glad I grant you this mercy. What in the... Reinforcements? No, just one! Cut him down!
Thank you, sir.
This one is promising. Who remains to offer us resistance?
A host of rebels led by Lord Cayenne hold the enclave across the river.
Lord Cayenne.
The king of the former king of Dorma, sir. They say he is one of the greatest swordsmen alive.
Is that what they say? Surely you jest.
That was Xenos Yegelvis, Legatus of the 12th, the Crown Bloody Prince. I heard he was strong, but that was frightening.
That was Lord Xenos.
Everything you are, your power, even your face, it vexes me. Go on. Lash out like the beast you are at an emissary and jeopardize the newfound peace between Dorma and the Empire. My lord was destined to lead us unto a glorious new age. Your light is nothing to his radiance. I will cherish this moment, lock it away within my heart, until the day we meet again.
You look troubled, my friend. Was it something he said?
Of all the memories to witness,
I had my doubts about him, but I would never have guessed he was a disciple of Xenos. My lord.
Calm yourself, Yugiri. I set no store by him or his enlightened brethren. But if by treating with them there is even the faintest hope we might secure the return of our conscripted brothers and sisters, I must play this game. After the way I risked their lives in the rebellion, I owe them that much.
My lord, you bear no blame for their fate.
If not blame, then responsibility. They were prisoners, and still I chose to fight, knowing they could be executed in retaliation. But now we have a chance to bring them home. If it means bargaining with a monster, so be it.
My lord.
Besides, I think he likes me. Which is more than some can say.
Thank you.
Can you truly remember nothing? Nothing at all?
Were we friends?
Yes. We were good friends, you and I. In fact, I've brought you a gift. Soon, as you gaze into that mirror, you will remember the woman staring back at you.
It's so pretty. Who are you?
How are you feeling, my lord?
Fine, now leave me.